co-founder and president of Road to Recovery. We're a 501c3 nonprofit charity based in New Jersey, and we help victims and their families. I'm also a former priest of the Archdiocese of Newark, New Jersey.
So what's it like to see victims come forward?
When victims come forward, it elates me. The greatest killer of sexual abuse victims is silence. And when victims come forward to speak about what has happened to them, they are now able to begin the recovery process. Silence kills. And if sexual abuse victims could just tell one other person, it kind of lances that boil. And then the poison is allowed to continue to creep out, hopefully, into significant recovery.
And then this isn't something someone just does overnight. It takes a while to come out.
Well, the average age of people that we work with is around 52 for people coming forward. This man is heroic. This John Doe is heroic. And I'm so edified by his courage that he was able to come forward. And now he has a whole lifetime ahead of him to recover. Whereas those of us in our 50s who came forward, we haven't had a whole lot of time to recover. So good for him. And I hope by his coming forward, he has helped so many others. And he'll never know the number of people that he has helped.
And then I guess over all of the cases with the diocese, what has the diocese learned?
I hope the diocese has learned that transparency and truth are the two T's of justice. They haven't been. The church has never really been transparent and never been truthful. So that's what we're looking for now. Unfortunately, we still haven't gotten it, but that's the message of Jesus, was truth and transparency. So that's what the diocese, it's a very simple message, and they don't have to continue to guard their image and their assets. What they need to guard is transparency and truth.